Hey Loomers, welcome to Original Designs by Fen. I'm Zach, I'm glad you're here. We're about to take a look at the Flower Petal Bracelet. The reason I like this one is that it kind of reminds me of a string of beads. You can see that what I'm calling each open bead is made out of two colors. In this example, we've got purple and white. And then each one is connected to the next by a third color. Here it's green. So it's a repeating pattern that you're going to want up to three separate colors for. It's pretty simple, so let's get started. I'm going to be using two different kinds of bands, actually. The main part of the bracelet I'm going to use midnight blue for, so we've already got three colors there. And remember, the blue in that does glow in the dark. And as more glow, I'm going to just be using, well, plain old glow in the dark. So that'll be the connector bands. So the first step of this pattern is actually going to be the most difficult. That's because we need to get a single rubber band around each of these four prongs individually. So what that means is that you're going to want to stretch out your first rubber band so that it has enough elasticity to make it all the way around. And you don't have to make it all in one go. I managed to do it this time. But if you find that you aren't able to get it around the last prong, you can first do one, then two, then three, and then loosen it up a bit, tug at the sides until you've got enough room to go around the last one, the fourth one. So this is how it should look for your first band. You can see it's crisscrossed against each one of them. It's got a tiny opening at the bottom. After that, it gets a lot easier. You crisscross your next color over two of the prongs that are opposite one another, as so, and then you do the same thing again for the other two prongs that you haven't used yet. Put that over here. And you push it all down. So that's actually the hardest step. Okay, so once you've got a grand total of three bands on your finger loom, you go ahead and pull the bottom one over. So you guys should have done this before if you're familiar with any other patterns when looming. So on all four prongs, you're going to pull up the bottom band and loop it over the top. And from there, we pretty much repeat the same thing, but in simplified manner, meaning that we don't have to crisscross any more of the bands. So after we've looped over the bottom band, we're going to put the connecting color over the top of all four prongs, like so. So you get an octagon. Go ahead and push it down and start looping. So again, by looping, I mean just pulling the bottom band from each prong over the top. And then, to get the main colors in again, put the two bands over the facing prongs. So one goes rectangular that way, and the next one goes rectangular across the other two. And you keep looping it over. And that is pretty much the pattern you're going to be repeating over and over again. So don't forget to push all your bands down and pull it out from the bottom when you've got enough, so you can keep enough space over the top. Alright, so you've gotten your bracelet to a pretty decent length. I'm happy with how long mine is. It's going to be good enough to be loosely wrapped on my wrist, not too tight. And to close off, we're going to take our C-clip. So I've got mine here. And if you've been working with a finger loom or any sort of loom before, you know that we're going to want to get all the bands off and inside a little space on the C-clip. So I'm going to hook them through like that, one by one, doesn't matter what order you go in. Personally, I would recommend doing this, there you go, while the bands are still on the finger loom. It makes it easier to hook them up. You take the C-clip, bring it to the other end, and you clip it through the bands there. I have to stretch them out a bit so I can have enough room. Get that guy in there. There we go. This one. I'm going to get the second one too. And there we go. And once you've got that C-clip on, make sure it fits nice and comfortably on your wrist. And you're all set. Alright, thanks for watching this tutorial, guys. Hope you like the design and the instructions, and we'll see you guys next time.